is Ben, ConEquip 101. Today in front of us, we have a mini excavator final drive. This particular final drive is out of a Kubota KX161-3, but overall, most excavators, mini and large, are set up the same way, okay? There's two major components to a final drive for an excavator. A hydraulic motor portion and a gear section called a gear reduction assembly. So we'll start with the hydraulic motor. On your machine, you've got hydraulic lines, 2, 3, 4, sometimes 5, hydraulic lines that go and plug into and feed hydraulic oil into the hydraulic motor portion of the final drive. If we get this off, break. So again, most hydraulic motors on final drives have a couple big ports and some small ports. So you've got a feed line and a return line. Don't screw those up when you hook it up. Read the instructions that are given to you, please, in the box. And if you don't know or understand, please call. You got main return lines. There's also a couple ports here on the side. These are case drain lines, typically. And some even have some extra ports on the side. This would be typically for a two-speed setup. So you can go really fast in your excavator. You must read the instructions to correctly hook the hoses up. So picture your final drive in the excavator this way, and you've got hoses. Sometimes they're rubber and a little flexible. Sometimes they're steel and, well, there ain't much flexibility at all. Gotta come in, hook up correctly. You've got your two-speed line maybe, can come up and in, and your case drain that can come up and plug right in. So that's kind of why we've got extra ports here, because what's on the other side? Well, it's turned this way. So it's okay. You can run two speed and your case drain down here. So that's why a lot of hydraulic motors on final drives for excavators have multiple ports. This ends up turning the shaft in here. And that shaft runs down, connects to the sun gear, and starts turning a bunch of other planetary gears all around. Those planetary gears end up turning the ring gear, and then this whole thing rotates. And why does it rotate ultimately? What is the whole final reason for a final drive? Is because you got a sprocket bolted to this, and that sprocket will turn the track. And it's an amazing process. And that, honestly, regardless of how big or small your excavator is, this is a basic rundown of what a final drive looks like for your excavator. I'm Ben, and this is ConEquip 101. Thank you.